Okay, look, when I test something, I test it thoroughly, okay? And so in this video, I want to give you a list of new features and updates in DaVinci Resolve 20 that don't work, or that need some improvement at least. Or there's actually another possibility. Maybe it's just all meer nuggerij van mijn entwege, as we say here in Belgium, so nitpicking. Or also possible, maybe I'm just missing something. But in that case, I'm pretty sure that you'll let me know in the comments, right? Right, so let me show you what I found. And just so you know, I've already downloaded and installed the new beta 2 update of DaVinci Resolve 20. Okay, here we go. And the first thing I want to show you is where the retime curve is, because they've updated now how keyframing works in DaVinci Resolve, and it's great, but a lot of you can't find the retime curve anymore. You know, it's that curve that you can use to smoothen out speed ramps or ease in and ease out speed ramps, things like that. So let's make a quick speed ramp here in this clip. Right click, retime controls, still the same. Add speed points. And then let's change the speed of the middle part there. Okay, and now the retime curve used to be here also when you right clicked on the clip, but it isn't anymore. In DaVinci Resolve 20, you can find it here now in the new keyframe editor window, but it's a bit hidden. So what you have to do is make sure that only the retime speed here is active. So disable the retime frame and then switch the view to curves here and boom, there's your retime curve. And then you can select the anchor points and smoothen the speed ramp, for example. But here's the thing, and I don't know if I'm remembering this wrong or if I'm confusing it with another editing program, but I was expecting it to create two anchor points here instead of one in the middle. Didn't it used to have two anchor points? I can't remember. So one at the top here and one at the bottom. I don't use speed ramping that much, so that's probably why I don't remember. But with two anchor points, you'd have more control, right, over the adjustments. It's a bit limited now with one anchor point in the middle. Now, there's a few workarounds, but still, I don't know. I think they could make the new keyframe editor even better, the keyframe editor even better with some small improvements. What do you think? And then next is a feature that, well, most of you will probably never use, and that's the new Alert Red Viewer Background. Now, what's Alert Red Viewer Background? Let me show you. Look, it's happened to me more than once that I upload a video, and then once it's uploaded, I notice that somewhere at some point in the video, I see the black viewer background, like this here, because I don't know, maybe I rotated the image or used some effect, whatever. But I didn't notice it while I was editing, because maybe the image was too dark in that area, or maybe the black was so narrow that I just didn't see it. Well, they've added this new feature now here in timeline view options that makes the background super bright red. Great, so far so good, right? But the problem is, for me at least, I use a lot of adjustment clips. And when I put an adjustment clip on top of my video clip, the red turns black again. So it's kinda useless for me now. So Blackmagic Design, please fix it for me. And this is an update that does work, but there's a small issue when you combine it with other new features, for example. So you can filter fonts now, right? Look, I only use 2 or 3 fonts 99% of the time for my videos. So instead of having all 1,233,269 fonts available and visible here, you can now go to Preferences, User, Editing, Text, and then display only specific fonts. And there you can load a text file in which you specify which fonts you want to see. So it acts like a filter. It's just a simple text file. And then when you use a text plus title, for example, you'll only see those fonts that you specified. Now, how exactly you do this is explained in the DaVinci Resolve 20 new features guide on their website. You can find it here under support. Now, like I said, this works great, but there's a small problem when you combine it with the multi-text tool, for example. But before I show you that, I want to show you something else first. And that's Audiio, the sponsor of this video. Because, well, I can see that you're still looking for a great music licensing platform, right? Well, look no more. Audiio has everything you need. A ton of high quality music, and it's high quality because it's all music from real artists, people who have a passion for creating music, but they also offer sound effects, and they make it super easy for you to find the perfect song, AI features like Hans AI or Link Match AI will help you find the music you need for your video in seconds. And you can get all this if you buy a pro subscription, which is 70% off for your first year. So that's just $59, guys. Now, I'm not gonna tell you what is or isn't a great deal, but that's a great deal. That's less than $5 a month to try it out for a year. So go check them out. And of course, thank you so much, Audiio, for supporting my channel. Okay, and now back to the problem with the text filters and the multi-text tool. For example, with the multi-text tool, because it does this with other text tools too. But the multi-text tool, you can find it here in titles. And the multi-text tool allows you now to add text in layers. So one title clip for different texts, different layers of text, with a ton of parameters, of course. And here you can see the layers, right? And once you've added a text box, you can activate the Fusion overlay here and then just move them around. But the problem is that the default font of these text tools is Open Sans. And so if you filter your fonts without including Open Sans, I have no idea how to pronounce it. Anyway, whenever you add a new text layer, you won't see it because the default font is Open Sans. And if you already had a few layers, for example, they will also disappear when you add a new layer. So you have to change the font first. So I guess the easiest solution so that you don't run into any problems is that you always include Open Sans in your filter file. Open Sans, I don't know. And this is another super small and seemingly unimportant update, but it could be super useful for a lot of people. If they fix one issue. Well, for me at least, they have to fix one issue. So in the media pool, when the thumbnail view is active, you can select the new custom sort option now. But it doesn't work when the snap to grid settings is enabled. When you disable that setting, you can move around all the thumbnails now however you want and group them literally whatever you want. And then when you turn on the snap to grid again, everything will snap, right? But what I would like to do is, for example, just move this one thumbnail here to in between these two. But it doesn't work. When snap to grid is enabled, you can't do anything. So I would like to be able to move just one or a group of thumbnails to wherever, and then that would then, you know, rearrange all the other thumbnails automatically, like the apps on your smartphone. Exactly that, yeah. But it doesn't do that. So fix that for me, please. Blackmagic Design, thank you. Okay, and then finally, whenever you start a new project, you can now specify a folder where Resolve will save all the media generated in DaVinci Resolve. So whenever DaVinci Resolve creates a new media file. And that sounds nice, but when you've specified that folder and then you go check in the project settings, you can see here that it will still save all the cache files, proxy files, and image stills in other folders. One general folder for all your projects. Now, I would like all of these to be set to that folder that I specified when creating a new project, especially the proxies. Wouldn't it make sense to have them also saved in that new specified folder for that project? I don't know. Mirnogre? Maybe. Or am I missing something? Also, when I want to render a clip in place, for example. Right click on a clip and then render in place, right? So it would render the effects. It would be nice if this would also default to that folder that you specified when you started a new project. I don't wanna like find or create a new folder here. I don't know, maybe it's all just mirenukere like I said, but there you go. I've been glorifying DaVinci Resolve for years. I felt like complaining a little bit. Thank you so much for watching and see you in the next one.